Hello, Power BI community. My name is Ryan Majitimer. I'm a product manager on the Fabric team, and welcome to the November 2023 Power BI update. Got all exciting features for you this month. If you want to see the full list of features, descriptions, screenshots, links to docs, that kind of thing, highly recommend you check out the blog. You can find a link for the blog in the description of this video. Also, you might want to watch till the end of this video for the community member spotlight. If you're unfamiliar with the Power BI community, you should definitely check it out. You can find it at aka.mswac/pbi-community. And you also might want to check out the Fabric community at aka.mswac/fabric-community. Well, without further ado, let's get into it. For reporting, we have button slicer, that's in preview, reference labels, also in preview, enhance your Q&A visual with suggested synonyms from Copilot, in preview, on-object interaction updates, also in preview. We've got a demo for this one. We're going to hand it over to Roseanne.
Those requested, this month, we're bringing you the ability to configure your pane switcher to stack panes instead of swap. So if you prefer the behavior from before, where the panes open side by side by default, you can now configure this setting by checking the new option for Always Open in New Pane from either the Options menu or the View ribbon. Also highly requested, this month we've also added the ability to resize the data flyout, which is the second flyout, from the Build button when working with long field names. We have also added the Add button back to Table. Originally, we had to remove the Add button from the table visual type, as the only chart element to add from this menu was the title and did not contain a default value. This was adding user confusion to the experience because simply turning on the title did not appear to change anything in the visual. Users had to go all the way to the format pane to be able to type in their visual's title. Last month, since we shipped placeholder text, we are now able to show the Add button again, because turning on title will now show the placeholder.
Thanks, Roseanne. Next, we have Azure Maps Visual now aggregates multiple data points at the same location. Narrative Visual with Copilot. Gonna hand it over to Carly for a quick demo.
Here in Power BI, let me go ahead and open up my Viz pane. I'm in edit mode. Let me go through, I have three pages here. This report is about hotel tourism data, and was actually created also by Copilot, but today we're going to talk about the narrative visual. So I have this nice empty spot on this report. I'm going to go ahead and click on the visual. I'm going to put it in this empty spot. So I can either choose to go with Smart Narratives, which was the old version of the visual, or the Copilot version. So we're going to go ahead and select the Copilot version. Now what this is going to do is create a textual summary generated by Copilot of the data that's visualized in my report. I can either start with some out-of-the-box suggestions that we have, give an executive summary, create a bulleted list of insights, or answer likely questions from leadership, or I can create a custom prompt to help summarize the data on my report. And either way, we'll generate a textual summary of these prompts. I can either do the current page, I can select the entire report, or I can even do specific combinations of visuals and pages. I can select or deselect what I want summarized versus not summarized. So let's go ahead and do across the entire report for now, and let's start with one of the out-of-the-box suggestions that we have here. So let's provide an executive summary across my entire report and see what happens here. And while it's thinking, how this works is it doesn't actually query the underlying data set. It only pulls from the visuals that are on the report, and even further, what I have selected in this little drop down here. All right, so we have an executive summary here. We can scroll through and get a good look at what's happening. And for every kind of section or bullet point here, we have references. So this gives an idea of where each section of the summary is pulled from in the report. So these references, if I hover over them, say what visual this little segment of data is being pulled from. And if I go ahead and click, It tells me specifically what visual, so it highlights. If it comes from a different page of the report, it'll kind of zoom me over to that page. So I can read through and see what's going on, you know, what kind of data it pulled, what kind of summary or what kind of insights it pulled. And I can use this text input to make some kind of formatting changes or tone shifts. So maybe I want to make this more professional. And this helps because I can't actually edit the results of the LLM. So I can't actually edit this text over here. But this being able to kind of edit the prompt itself gives me some kind of control over what the output of this summary is. So this helps give some element of control here. So I can make this more professional. We've also seen people do some cool things where they create a table of contents for their report and do some other cool things like that. So this made it a little bit more professional here. I can also do really cool things. Let's say maybe I want to, again, I can see that this is about hotel tourism and I can see some of the locations here. So let's imagine that I have some stakeholders. Maybe they're really focused. Let's see, it looks like this is from 2021 and one of the locations here, I think that there's some Hawaii items. So let's say I want to focus this summary on Maui visits because the stakeholders are really focused on improving tourism in Maui. So I can focus this summary specifically on what's been going on in with tourism data in Maui. And it'll create me a very focused and nuanced summary of what the data looks like in Maui. And this is super helpful because if this is what I want my stakeholders or my end users to focus on, I can, as an author, create this really nuanced, focused summary and plop this right on my report. And people don't have to sift through the visuals. They can focus on this specifically. And I can even do some formatting shifts here where, you know, I can make this shorter or longer and direct it with custom prompts to specify what I want people to focus on even more directly. And this is kind of what we can do with the summary here. So I can put this into reading view. I can go ahead and save this. And this is what it looks like.
Thanks, Carly. On to modeling. We have datasets renamed to semantic models. Power BI semantic model support for Direct Lake on Synapse Data Warehouse. DAX Query View to write and run DAX queries on your model. I'm going to hand it over to Zoe for a demo.
We are thrilled to announce the public preview of the DAX Query View, a fourth view in Power BI Desktop that can run DAX queries. Not only does it run DAX queries, but it also generates a number of DAX queries with quick queries. On a table, you can go ahead and preview data or preview the columns with column statistics, which will generate a DAX query for you telling you all about the columns such as counts, mins, and maxes. You can also go to an individual column and see the data in that column, and also do the column statistics query on an individual column. For measures in your model, you can define them all at once in a single query to see all the DAX expressions and how they evaluate. And on an individual measure, you can go ahead and evaluate to see that value in a DAX query. You can hover to see the DAX expression, or you can use inline to define that in the DAX query. You can edit the DAX query and then run that to see how that changes the output. And when you're happy with that, you can update the model with the new DAX expression for that measure. Finally, as measures tend to reference other measures in their DAX expression, you can define them all at once and then edit them and see them in the DAX editor. In the report view, the visuals themselves also have DAX queries. You can access them in the Performance Analyzer, and now you can simply run them in the DAX query view. Finally, if you already have a DAX query, you can format it with the click of a button in the DAX query view. You can also comment a line or uncomment a line, just like you would with any query editor. So try it out today. Thank you.
Thanks, Zoe. Next, we have Edit Your Data Model in Power BI Service Updates and Selection Expressions for Calculation Groups Preview. For data connectivity, we have Azure Resource Graph, which is a new connector, Prophecy, we have a connector update. Bloomberg Enterprise Data and Analytics, a connector update. Dremio, a connector update. And Celonis, also a connector update. First service, we have Explore, which is in preview. And we're going to hand it over to Roseanne for a demo.
Within Power BI, there are many times users may need to perform an ad hoc exploration of their data. This could be an analyst who just got access to a new data source and wants to spend some time learning about the data before building a report off of it. Or maybe this could be a business user who needs an answer to a specific question to include in a PowerPoint presentation, but the report they're using doesn't quite have the answer they're looking for. Creating a new report from scratch in these cases is a large hurdle, just to get a quick answer or screenshot for a deck. I'd like to introduce you to the new Explore feature that just hit public preview, where users have a lightweight and focused experience to explore their data. Similar to exporting and building a pivot table in Excel, now, directly within Power BI, users can quickly launch the new Explore experience to begin creating a matrix or visual to get the answers they need, without all the distractions and extra complexity of building a report. Here, I have a Hawaii tourism semantic model that was just sent over my way, and I'd like to explore it. So, I open the Options menu to find the new Explore experience. Once here, I can start to explore this data. Over on the right side, you'll find the data pane that looks very familiar to our reporting experience. I'd like to check out which island in Hawaii has the most visitors. So I add visits and island to my matrix. After sorting some of visits, I can see that Oahu is actually the most popular island based on this data. And I can open the visual panel to see the visual representation of the same data. Now I'd like to see why there are a lot of visitors to Oahu. So I add trip purpose to my matrix. I only care about Oahu, so I can quickly add a filter using the Add Filter button up here at the top. I can also swap the visual type to be a column chart to see this a bit more easily. I can also swap how the view looks by using the split view to see it vertically, but I think I actually preferred it horizontal. Now that I know that Oahu is the most popular island for tourism and the most popular reason is for vacation, let me go ahead and add a filter for trip purpose as well. Now I want to check if the visits to Oahu for vacation follow any sort of seasonality trend. So I add date to my visual. Now I have a full hierarchy to take a look at, but I think I only care about what might change month to month instead of year to year. So I go ahead and drill just to look at month. I can also change the visual type again to be a line chart so this is easier to read. Ah, much better. Now I can see from the line chart that we have a lot more visitors coming to Oahu for vacation in the spring time frame, but it really starts to dip around the holidays. So this is something I want to send over to my colleague. So first I'm going to save this exploration and then share it. You can see the saved exploration now in my workspace. Now I simply just have to open this back up and click share. And there you have it, the new Explore experience in action, meant to be lightweight for all of your ad hoc needs. While this feature is in preview, we'd love to hear what you think. How useful are you finding it? What can make it more useful for you? Please let us know in our survey.
Thanks, Roseanne. Next, we have OneLake integration for import mode semantic models. Preview, RLS WEC OLS security and stored credentials for direct lake semantic models, preview, shareable cloud connections for semantic models, generally available, semantic model scale-out, generally available, show visuals as table, preview, advanced filtering for paginated reports. Moving on to embedded analytics, we have dynamic dataset binding for paginated reports. For visualizations, we have the editor's pick of the quarter, and those are Performance Flow by XViz, Gala Geo for Power BI, Calendar by DataNow, Image Pro by CloudScope, and Sparkline by OKViz. New visuals in AppSource are Apex Gantt Chart. We've also got Zebra PI Tables 6.6, introducing text columns, Funnel Chart by PowerViz, and create interactive timelines with full control. For other, we have enhanced accessibility in paginated reports authored in Report Builder, as well as Skill Up on Fabric with Microsoft Learn Cloud Skills Challenge. And now we've made it to the community member spotlight. Each month we pick a community member that's gone above and beyond, and this month it is Rataf1983. Rataf has been a community member since 2022, is a super user, a community blogger, has over 400 kudos received and over 300 solutions authored. Well, that's all we have for you for this month. Let us know in the comments, what was your favorite feature? Also, do you have any feedback on these videos, the blog, community, anything like that? I'd love to hear about it. Again, my name is Ryan McJittimer. Like, comment, subscribe. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one.